LibreOffice Base is a tool to create and manage databases. But the first thing I want to point out is we don't call this LibreOffice Database because it's not a database by itself. The default database for LibreOffice Base is HSQLDB, but it can also be used as a front end to read in other databases like MySQL or an Access database. For this tutorial series, we're going to treat it as if it were an all-in-one database, although it's not, meaning we're only going to use the default HSQL database. When we open up LibreOffice Base, it brings up this database wizard and asks us, what do we want to do? Do we want to create a new database, open an existing database file, or connect to an existing database? Now, if we had a database out there, we could select that, connect to an Access database, or down here we see MySQL. I don't have any out there now, but if I did, we could create our own forms and reports from it. What we want to do is create a new database. So I'm going to select that radio button and click on Next. And I'm also going to mention, let's go back, Save and Proceed does the same thing as Next. You click this, brings you to the next screen. Now it's asking us, do we want our database registered? It really doesn't matter right now. We can always register it later. I will mention that registering your database just makes your database viewable to the different LibreOffice modules. It has nothing to do with any online registry of any kind. If you want to know a little more about how the registry works right now, you might want to check out the LibreOffice Writer mail merge videos I made. We will look at how registered databases work later in the series, but that's way down the road. So I'm not going to register my database right now, but I will open the database for editing. I'm going to click Finish, and I want to give this a name. I'm going to give our database the name ODB01 Employees, and click Save. We told it to open our database, and that's what it did. So we see it up at the top on our title bar, ODB01 Employees. And right now we have an empty database. We're at our main screen, and we see three windows. One that says Database, one says Tasks, and the other says Tables. Under Database, we have Tables selected. If I change this to Queries, we see our Tasks changed, and our third window now says Queries. And the same thing happens for forms and reports. We're going to start with tables. Since our database won't do us any good without any data in it, and to hold the data, we're going to need a table. Looking over in our tasks, this top one says create a table in design view. And the description for that is create a table by specifying the field names and properties as well as the data types. That's the one we want, so I'm going to click on it. This brings up something that looks like a spreadsheet. With three columns, we see field name, field type, and description. To help us visualize what we want to create, I'm going to use the team contact list we created in the Calc series with a few changes to it. Here we see we've got last name, first name, gender, start date, end date, phone number, and so on. When we formatted our Calc spreadsheet, we used different formatting for our text fields, for our date fields, and for our numeric fields. We're going to do the same thing here. One difference between our new database and the Calc employee list is we want each employee to have its own number. Just like most companies give employee numbers to their employees, or schools might give a student number to each student. We're going to do the same thing here, and we want LibreOffice Base to enter it in for us. In our field name, we're going to call this Employee ID. LibreOffice Base wants us to enter this in as a text field. We're going to change this to Integer. Down in our field properties, we have a thing called Auto Value. We want to turn this to Yes. So this will auto-populate this field for us, giving each employee a different number, starting with 0 and counting up. I'm going to put a description in. We're going to say this is the unique employee number. Looking back at our calc sheet, We now have last name and first name. This one we can use a text varchar. Looking down at our field properties, it's asking us if this entry is required. We want to say yes. We need to have a last name if we're going to give them an employee ID. The length is 100, but when we see varchar, that means variable characters. If we don't use all 100 characters, it will just cut it off to what we need and only use the memory which we need. So we prefer varchar because that's a little more efficient than fixed. Giving it a description. Now the first name, we're going to make the first name required as well and leave the rest alone. And we'll put in a description here. Next one we have is gender. And instead of variable characters this time, we're going to make this one fixed. And we're going to give it a length of 6. Under our description, we're going to say it must be either male or female. Next, we've got the start date. And we're going to make this one a date field. And since the descriptions are not required, I'm just going to enter in the rest without any descriptions. Now we have our entire table entered. The only other thing I want to point out right here is if I want to add a field, I can go up to where it is, right click, and insert a row. New field. But once I save this database, I can't do that. Any new field I want to enter after I save this database will have to go at the bottom. You'll see later that it really won't be that big of a deal. But just to let you know, we can change the order before we save the table. Let's save it right now. I'm going to give it a name of employees. So now we've got an empty table inside of our database. To open up this table, I can double click on it. And there's all the fields that we just entered. If I right-click on this, it brings up a shortcut menu. We can copy this table, delete it, rename it, edit, or open. When we double-clicked it, we opened it. Now we're going to take a look at edit. Edit brings us back into the edit mode. Edit mode is where we just were, where we added all our fields to the table. We may want to add or delete a field. This is where we would make that kind of change. Now I'm going to open it. And let's add some data. Now this first one we said was auto field, so we don't need to enter that field. Let's get our values from our calc table. We've got last name, Taylor, Mark, he's a male, start date was 2005-10-31. To get to the next row, I'll just hit Tab. So we see that our first employee ID turns to 0. If I start to type in the next one, and I put in his last name, Now I try to save this table. It gives me an error because our last name and our first name were required fields. So I have to give it at least a last name and a first name. Now I can save the table. I've typed in the rest of the data from the calc spreadsheet. So now we've got some data in our table in our database. So I'm going to save my table and save my database. And I'll put this out on the website in case anyone wants to download it from there.